Put your hands together for these kids coming in, please. Always nice to have a bit of Polynesian entertainment while you're enjoying your food and beverage.
Thank you.
Ashby's. Really, really big round of applause for them, and it's a great effort, I guess. Great effort. Now, this next item that we've prepared for you, I do believe this is your sister Bella, who's going to... Oh, sorry, there's a second dance. Sack the MC. Well, I do take that comment back. They are performing a second dance. And I'll tell you what, these kids look really good. I'm proud of them to be in their Polynesian colours, the blue colour, which is my favourite colour. Beautiful. Put your hands together. And actually, you guys don't look too bad yourselves. I think I've already told you. You're absolutely stunning. You guys even Samoan. Beautiful. One of the most beautiful people on earth, eh? I see it every morning when I look in the mirror. I wake up and I think, Eshays, look at me, man. Oosh. Tell you the value of our real estate in our suburb improved when I bought a house there. The prices went up. Do your neighbours a favour, do your estate a favour, buy a house. I guarantee you the value of your street will go up. Big Polynesian, being proud. Here we go.
It's wild.
Let's go.
excellent performance. Guys, let's do that in 4 days. Beautiful, recent mother, Taylor Villiers. Put your hands together, please. Jeez, that wasn't much noise. Make some noise.
It's not going to be those giant 10-minute speeches, but I just wanted to say something. Growing up, we had our big cousins, which was all the older ones, and then our little cousins, which was like kind of the category we fed into. And then, And even though Iggy was always a year older than me, he was always doing what the older cousins were doing. And it wasn't like partying and going out. It was more like cleaning up after and like fouls and stuff. Yeah, that's tough. And me being only a year younger than Iggy, I used to feel so bad for him because even as kids, whenever we all used to hang out at Auntie Sue's house, all of us kids would be outside just running amok. And then Iggy would get caught in to go rub Nana's back, and Iggy's like, I used to feel so bad. So Iggy. That's probably why Iggy was always like Nana and Grandpa's golden child. Iggy's just always been that guy and always had a special place in Nana and Grandpa's heart. Having someone like Iggy in your life is like having a brother you never knew you wish you needed. Because Iggy's the type of person that respects you whether he's known you for 2 minutes or he's known you his whole life. When I tell you he is there for anything, he is there for you for anything. If you need someone to talk to, Iggy will listen to you for as long as it takes. If you need someone to cry to, Iggy's shoulder is always there without a doubt. If you need a lift, he'll pay for your Uber because bro's 21 and still doesn't have his license. What are you doing, Iggy? No, for real, Iggy's just the heart of our family. Something personal for me is that when my partner passed away, we were obviously doing our own thing. He was always working and I was pregnant, being a mom. But every time I posted something of my partner, Iggy would always reply back with a I love you cuz, or I hope you're okay, or if you need anything, I've got you. And realistically, people always say stuff like that just to be nice. But knowing Iggy, even a small message like that, I know deep down he means it and would be there for me for whatever it was. And in saying that, Stella, I don't know where she is, but Stella. Stella's done a beautiful job raising you. Iggy, I'm so glad that we get to celebrate you tonight, and with everything you've gone through, I'm so proud of you and how far you've come. I'm forever grateful to have you as my brother, and I love you always.
Wow, what a beautiful speech. Thank you, Taylor. Thank you, Taylor. I'll tell you what, I'm just looking on the list here. Does anyone know Nico? So Nico was supposed to dance here tonight, but guess what? He got gout, or sabun word mumu. I've got a laugh, and put up your hands if you get gout. Anyone in here? Also, put your hand up, mate. I know you got gout. Yeah, anytime it's going to rain, you know he's... Poor Nico. Put our hands together for Nico. He's not here, he's got gout. And now, ladies and gentlemen, an absolutely magnificent dance we're going to have here. We'd like to invite Bella on stage, Iggy's sister, to perform a Samoan dance. Hands together, please make some noise.
Let la la ya.
Sunrise. An incredible performance. Thank you, Bella. And she's put up with him, put up with his smelly shoes and stuff. Endured his Eshay lad ways. I'd now like to call on Talia, the love of Iggy's life, to say a few words. Put your hands together, make some noise, please.
Today, as you step into this exciting world of adulthood, I want you to know that I've got your back no matter what. We're stepping into this new chapter together, and I can't wait to see where life takes us. Here's to you, to the man you've become and the man you're still becoming. Here's to more adventures, more laughter, and more love. Happy 21st birthday, love.
Short and sweet. Make some noise again for Talia. Thank you, the beautiful Talia. Thank you for putting up with my nephew and his bad jokes. Ladies and gentlemen, we do have another item right now. I'd like to call on Bella again. This time she's going to take the floor with Liliana performing the Samoan dance I assume. Oh, okay, we're just setting up the music. Anyone got any bad jokes they want to tell? Now's the time to say it. Yeah? I've got no bad jokes, though. My jokes are pretty dry. So, I'll just keep talking while this guy's setting this up.
Mama,
Hallelujah. It's now that time of the evening where we get to cut the cake and sing happy birthday. Jeez, you're getting tall, bro. Wow, that's a beautiful cake, isn't it? It looks very Samoan. I'm impressed. Looks really good. Are we lighting this candle on this cake, or? Or is it a magic cake?
Yeah, you're gonna light up. Yeah, got the lights up, babe.
Someone wanna light the candle? Sorry? Oh. How's that, the birthday boy's lighting his own candle? Let's sing happy birthday, Iggy.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Iggy. Happy birthday to you.
Samoan. So proud of you. Put your hands together, Peggy. Okay, well, that's the cake. We will cut that at some time. There's no knife here. Iggy, want to use your hand and karate chop it? No, don't do that. Okay, we're going to present the key. We've got a key presentation, so sit down, Iggy. This is a tradition where we have the key presented to Iggy. This key's been prepared by the family, by Iggy's godmother, who is Auntie Sana. Put your hands together for Auntie Sana. Everybody knows Auntie Sana. You know, Sana's the one that's got those Facebook, you know, where she's doing all those facials on Facebook, and I can't watch the videos. Put your hands together, make some noise for Sana.
Five
times,
I just want to say thank you so much to our Heavenly Father for today, for giving us, for blessing us all, for bringing us all here under this roof, giving us, you know, good health, mind and body, and for making our way here to celebrate this milestone for our son Iggy. So thank you, Lord. As you all know, okay, my name is Susanna Salah Donevsky. I am one of Iggy's many mums. I am Iggy's godmother. Ignatius Patrick Biliae was born this day back in 2002 in Blacktown Hospital. So what is the time? What's the time now?
10 to 8.
Ignatius was born at 12 o'clock this day back in 2002. So he's actually 21 and 7 hours and 50 minutes. That's how old Iggy is today. So thank you, Lord, for today. When Ignatius was born, it was such a big thing in our family. The birth of Ignatius was the golden child. Ignatius was the baby of the family. We had many babies before Iggy, and we had many babies after Iggy, but the birth of Ignatius was something that, with my late parents, my mum and dad, Iggy's grandparents, I saw something in them that I'd never seen before. It gave them a new life. You know, it made them young again. Shortly after Ignatius was born, his father, Adrian Vorich, was posted out to Iraq. And I believe he's still there at this time, so that's why he can't join us. But he sends his love, Ignatius. Hoping you have a wonderful day today. But as I said, Ignatius was that golden child. Ignatius brought so much happiness, not just to my mum and dad, but our whole family. You know, it wasn't his that he was the best looking baby that our family's ever had. You know, Ignatius had the golden locks, he had the fair skin, he had, you know, my father used to say, oh, come a little Iggy for if it is. So you know, he had the flared nostrils that my father always used to talk about. And he had these eyes like, you know, Iggy would cry, whatever Iggy wanted, he would get, you know, because he would just flash his eyes would turn color, they used to be green, and then they'll go hazel, then they'll go light brown. And, you know, Iggy just got everything that he wanted because he was the special child. He was our golden child. Iggy had many mothers. So the first one is his biological mother, Stella. And then me, his almost a grandmother, sorry. I am a grandmother. Then me, his godmother. Then he had my mum, Ignatius's grandmother, who would do anything for Iggy, whatever. And then Ignatius' second mother, which is my late sister Jennifer. And this is, when we came in with Ignatius on that entrance, this is a photo of Ignatius and his second mum, Jenny. Jenny would do anything for this boy. They had a very special bond, and nobody could break that bond, no matter what. So this is why we've got Jenny here with Ignatius. And we also have a photo here of my mum and dad with Ignatius. Now, Ignatius went to school at St. John Vianney's from kindy up to year six. This is one of the many awards that Ignatius won. Now, this is a very special award that was only given to the student of the term. And Ignatius won this on many occasions at St. John Vianney's growing up. So there you go. Can we give a hand to Ignatius? And this photo really depicts the love that my mum and dad had for Ignatius. Like, my mother had one limb, she's very sick. My dad is in his walker, very sick. But they made the effort to go and see Iggy get this award. So that's just to show, to demonstrate the love that my parents had for Ignatius. So Ignatius went to school after St. John Vianney's. Then Ignatius went to school at St. Agnes in Rudy Hill. He graduated there in 2020. Ignatius got his baptism. All his sacraments of the church were received at St. John Vianney's. After Ignatius did his first Holy Communion, he took he joined his older cousins serving altar service and joining their grandfather serving at the altar at St. John Vianney. Now, this was a chore that my father was very proud of, you know, being able to teach his grandchildren, especially Ignatius, on how to serve at the altar at church. So that was a milestone for my father. Growing up, Ignatius did soccer when he was growing up, and then when he hit his late teens, he played league. So he played for Rouse Hill, then it was Pitchambury and Doonside. Ignatius graduated in 2020 at St. Agnes. He did what every, you know, responsible, decent young man would do, you know, find a job to help his mum. So Ignatius did that. His first job was rendering with his Uncle Zach. And then the second one was Uncle Pat doing traffic controlling. And I believe he's just completed his scholarship in scaffolding. There you have it. And the, you know, what we get back, thank you. Can we have a round of applause for that? I think it deserves it. The one thing that we get back from a lot of people that we hear with Iggy and what we see in our family is Iggy is very humble. He is very respectful. Ignatius will do anything for you. You know, he'll smile for ngang ebe fa abalvalia. But you know, and he will do it, you know. With our other kids are good kids, but Ignatius would never answer you back. Ignatius is so respectful, regardless of aunties, uncles, mum, dads, he's very respectful. He'll always be there, as Taylor mentioned, who always has your back. So I think to round it off is Ignatius. What is written on Ignatius' date of birth, on the milestone of his date of birth in the book of Proverbs, is this. And I think this really sums up the character of Ignatius. It says, one who guards his mouth and tongue guards his soul from troubles. So, ole, 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 ilona, nutu, malona, lau, lau, faiva. E chausi, ya te ia, ia, pua, pua, ngā. And that perfectly describes Ignatius. So I'm just going to ask everyone if I could please have your participation in this. It's a prayer that I want us all to please stand up. If we can all put out our right hand, stay Iggy, over Iggy, Ignatius, and I will just say this prayer. Dear God, we come before you today with a heart full of gratitude and love for our son Ignatius. He is our precious gift in our lives, and we ask for your guidance and blessings over him. Please watch over our son, keep him safe from harm, and guide him in his journey through life. Grant him wisdom in his decisions, resilience in the face of challenges, and success in his endeavors. May he grow in good health, both physically and emotionally. May his heart be filled with love, compassion, and understanding for others. May us as parents provide him with the love, support, and guidance he needs to thrive. We trust our son into your loving hands, knowing that you are, that your protection is steadfast and your love is unwavering. Please bless him with your grace and help him become the best version of himself. In your name, we offer this prayer, trusting in your divine care and guidance. Amen. Thank you, everybody. And Ignatius, I just want to present to you this gift. This 21st. Oh, that's really heavy. That's it there, but I do have another gift. 21st, Ignatius. May God bless you always. Just got this 18 karat gold crucifix, which has been blessed for Ignatius. That's from us. We didn't give him that 21st key was from Brisbane, from Sophia P. So, not from us, but thank you anyway. I'll take that credit for that. A special boy and such a delight, such a blessing to our family. We are so proud that he is part of our family. Thank you, Ignatius. Thank you so much for everything that you do.
Sorry. I think my eyes are worse than Susan. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for Susan. That was an absolutely wonderful speech and a very true account of Iggy's life. You know, when Iggy used to serve at the church, I came to the church and I seen Iggy in these altars, I thought, what if I feel old and I thought he's the first priest. Then he met Talia. Ready? Put your hands together. Big Iggy. Okay, well, I'll tell you what, we keep rolling on with these speeches. I'd now like to call up on Keke, Iggy's sister, and a sibling photo once they're all called up. Keke?
Hi everyone, I'm Rosa, aka Keke, aka Iggy's favourite sister. Iggy is my eldest brother, and I'm here to tell you a few things about Iggy. Four facts you may not know about Iggy. Number one, Iggy is an excellent cook. Iggy is especially good at cooking Italian. When Iggy was living at home, he would often help mom in the kitchen. All my older siblings can help cook, unless of course it's microwave food. So it's always special when Iggy comes over and cooks. Number two, Iggy is a hard worker. Iggy never misses a day of work. It doesn't matter if it's a really hot day or a really cold day. Iggy will always go to work. Iggy will even go to work sick because he wants the money. Sometimes he'll be gaming all night with Ben, Neil, Benno, Scoppe, and Stan, and won't go to bed till after 3 a.m. But he will always be up at 5:30 a.m. to get ready for work. Number 3, Iggy has a girly side. When Iggy was still in high school, he asked Mom to take him to the beauty salon to get his eyebrows waxed. Nowadays, Talia waxes his eyebrows for him and does his skincare and beauty routine. Number 4, Iggy is really protective. Iggy is really protective with his family. When Iggy and Ben were in high school, a boy was bullying Ben. When Iggy found out, he beat him up, and the school had to call Mom to go and pick him up. He was suspended from school for a few days, but the boy never picked on Ben ever again. And even when Iggy sometimes hears me and Vitu talking about our crushes, he threatens to beat them up. You see, that's really protective of him. Thank you, Iggy, for being a great brother to all of us. Helping when someone needs something, having a loving and caring heart, for being a helpful person to everyone, and when someone is sad, you make them happy. This shows that you have a very big heart. You are the best helping and caring brother to me. Even if Ben is my favorite brother, I still love you a lot. You told me that you changed your siblings' nappies when we were babies. You even blew up the pool with Dad so that Biani, me, and Fatou can swim in it. The only reason why Ben is my favorite is because Ben is here more than you. I would like to see you more, but I know you're busy. Thank you for being the best brother you could possibly be, and I love you so much. As you know, I sense that you're a helping and caring brother, but you're also nice too. You are so funny that everyone wants to hear your jokes. I love you so much because you want to help someone or help with something. You are already 21 today, and I only turned 9 this year. That is crazy. That means you're like 12 years older than me. You have a good relationship with a lot of people, and that's really good. Roses are red, violets are blue. You are the best, and I love you. Thank you for listening. Happy birthday, Iggy.
Excellent speech. You guys getting a photo or something? Or what's going on? Come up for the photo, yeah? All the siblings.
Mom, if my dad is a little more calm, the more I'm going to calm away, gang nou dan ko sien ki my ekie vir my nou ko Stella va moene kama ja ekie na siel ol moene ek na siel ol mo pa pou ke my le ma ko kwad fa dan ko fina sa le la va mo ai ekie ekie na siel e le foi fa mo na ko ako ako los ekie na siel ya ma ek na siel ya ngala nga ma ko my ai le Yeah, all the visitors who more you can follow my. Yeah, I'm going back. All the hope for you, Marco Alma, get them far away still over my room. Come on, you get a kawa. You know, kawa or you run in Afghanistan. Yeah, and I saw solo. Yeah, and I saw papa, my pompoya. Yeah. Laku lola, you know, I said, sing a Stella, came here. Yeah, laku lopa. Laku lopa, for my lopa. Eu vou olhar para o meu pai fama. É a primeira vez que eu vou olhar para o meu pai. Eu vou olhar para o meu pai. Eu vou olhar para o meu pai. Mãe, ele vai para o meu pai. Eu vou olhar 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 para o meu pai.
Together.
and pray for so-and-so because they're stupid. Put your hands together for Sophia. Ladies and gentlemen, just before we have the final speeches tonight, I would like now to extend a very warm welcome to anyone that's here tonight that would like to say anything very quickly about Iggy. Extending a warm welcome, anyone. I mean, it's ad hoc, it's not on the program, but I'm opening it as the MC. I'm asking anyone here that wants to say something very quickly to come up and say something now. Our program's running ahead of time, so we do have a few minutes to spare. Anyone take me up on that offer? There's a lot of people here that are never short of words. Now's the time. Okay, I'll tell you what. I'm going to call on our final speech of the evening. Now I'd like to call on Senil Toliafoa. Senil Courtney are here from France. Senil plays over there in the bed, 3 hours south of Paris, and he's here tonight with Iggy. Put your hands together, please.
Cheers.
Yeah.
I also like to just sing a little song on behalf of Nan and Grandpa and my mum and Stan. Everyone just join in with me.
This is my song, my Savior God to thee. How great thou art.
and gentlemen, I'll tell you what, I'm looking forward to this. My daughter's dancing in this, and look at these beautiful young ladies. Put your hands together, let's make some noise for this. Make some noise if you're having a good time. That table over there is always, that's my loud auntie, and I love her because she always makes noise when I ask her to. Sometimes she jumps on the table, she dances up and down, and that's what I know is time to go home. Can we get an Esha? Esha. Esha, mate. I used to be a rat in my old day, but now I'm in a wife, I'm going to be responsible for what I'm saying. Mitch. Everyone knows Mitch? I love this guy. Sounds like as it is. Anyway, we've got another item coming up. One more song.
Yeah!
Hey, we've got one more performance.
I'm sorry, I kicked it by mistake.
You can't kick it by mistake. You
get up with the ball.
No, you will pick it up.
Yeah,
I oversight. Mari. Yeah. Olewa, Maika Waku, Wakako, Mata, Yasu, Kaku, Faola, Yasu, Sumai, Kaku, Faola, Yasu, Kiris. Olha só, mano, salmo, meu boy. Ya, o afafo cai, o mania, e nem ainda o cofa cai, mas o cofa agora. Mas qual que fala, mania? Olha, se meu lá, o faiga era a ninguém, e o cali aí, e o cabo mafa, mas o cofa se o vai, ya, o cabio se meio do mais, o mapa se faz, mele lei o cofa. A ninguém com lá, mas salmo, meu boy. Ya la mai fanka e fai ore ma a ngē e ai leo ma ko maku ya ko sa mai la ma boa ko le mo musu musu mai la ka dio ma le asfa ma o sa e se fai me alofa e yo ma anko e o sa ka sa mai i lo maso de so e o sa pele o sa maku ya o wasa se foi a fincada no oile ben poier new col di uno qua oi oi foi le rei moli me suma e a allow che fosse lea e a vole vole christmas qua lo sa la pensi di lo sa e ne lo blau e le gedi e po ya malesi me ala rewa ya 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 si sei lo walewa mawa ya rewa to fake aku le keke asa kawa ma fulfula ku fe le keke ma kula ma ya ya ne fa pete ya ne ya ne la pe ku ko le ai ma ne ne fo la ko me wa ko si se ya ne fa ko me fo i ma e o be aka ko le di ya is ya le uso ya kelo passa ya la me fenka la fiosa qual la in sa falanda causa le buena la vale un ma mo che sta mo per cala mai sa mo il sole ca fa no vai poi poi se forse con che va qua io ti ho era la che ho così ho che era con ca poi e vai oggi spasso ya le noa la mo fakka la mo oye le wa ko ya le swafa la mo oye le kuyomo le fakka le ko ku sala fai ya ola u ka le mo le dispas ko ke ko ka sa sa ki lo la ka ke ka sa wa ima na yi ko sa mai ko sa mai yi me u ko sa mai ya ma ko sa mai ko lo la ya ya ko ko Ayo sampai, kau harus dismas, dismas kau kau. Ya malu lepas, malu lepas. Ya Eli, terus. Ya langgan lu mau mau aku, ya kau lu kau ya kau lewat fuyu kau pasak. Nama fikir ya, ya freama, ya freama. Ya kalau kalau ya kusina walau sah teksi kalau sah ini dia flaf. Ya pilih ya oleh bawa dia dah sejuta salah. Dah itu sekarang lagi dah. Kebangan mah by far dia. Oh ya tuh esanikah. Ya, senyum. Yang ada kira semai. Ewa bawa, kita perlu jatuhkan dua sefakas. Ibu yang kaku, wahai sefakas. E la facciata con il spazio di un cacco, fai un confare, 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 fai un
Samoan formality is over and done with. Thank you very much to my beautiful Samoan family. I'm very proud of our Samoan custom. And well, we're going to hand you back over to DJ now. We'll get the house lights out. Let's get this party rocking. Let's make some noise. Hey!
Thank you. gentlemen, New Zealand All Blacks performing the haka.